What is up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Jesse Spec YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking about the MR2 and the 2ZZ engine that you see right away beside me. I received a lot of parts ready for my swap, so I thought, why not make a video on showing you exactly what you need in order to make the swap successfully. So let's dive right into it. Peace. The first part on your list in order to do the swap, as you can see right here, this is the stock header. This will not work with your MR2 exhausts. So first thing you need to buy is a header. So here you can see this one. Very nice piece made by Monkey Wrench Racing. This video is not sponsored by them, although I wish they would have. And so they give you everything in order to install these parts, including all the hardware. As you can see, very nice parts. The next element you will need in order to do the swap, as you can probably see, I will show you a little clip of that. The original dipstick of the Celica will not fit, so you need a special MR2 compatible one here, as you can see right here. The next elements are related to the shifter linkage. I have the engine, as you know, the engine and transmission came from a Toyota Corolla, the TS version with the 2ZZ, and sadly that gearbox only works, so the 6-speed transmission from the Corolla fits in the car perfectly. The only problem is the shifter linkage will not work. So what you need in order to do that is buy this shaft also.
Not sponsored by Monkey Wrench Racing, hint, hint, hint.
And the other thing you will need is the reverse block out cap. I will show you on the stock transmission where that comes on to, and I will do a video also on exactly how to install these parts and convert your transmission so it's compatible with an MR2. And of course, little washers included in the kit. When doing your 2ZZ swap, you will need absolutely the stock Loom of the 1ZZ engine. And there are multiple ways to do that. You will need the stock 2ZZ ECU with the Loom of the 1ZZ. So this one, this Loom that you see on this engine will not work. So we need to remove that and take the 1ZZ Loom off the 1ZZ, put it on this engine and use it with the stock ECU. Or there's another option that I have used as well, and that will perfectly plug in. As incredible as that may seem, it actually will plug in and the engine will start and everything. There will be, however, one thing, as we all talk about, the lift. The lift will not work, and this is where this additional harness is coming, so we can actually plug in the lift of the engine, so it actually can work. And there will be some minor cabling adaptations to do. I will be doing that. I did not decide to buy the plug-in harness that they make for it, because being a mechanic I'm interested in ECUs, I thought might as well try a little bit, and it's really nothing complicated, except especially that it's all very well documented, so we're just gonna go with that. Stock ECU lift harness. How do they call that? They call it the VVL connector kit. This is what it looks like. One essential part that makes the install possible, and people say that the 2ZZ swap is one of the easiest swaps on the planet. It is, but if you don't have this, it's never gonna work. So basically it's a fully sort of plug-and-play installation. but there is one engine mount bracket that if you do not have this, it will not fit into the MR2. So again, Monkey Wrench Racing makes this. And this is definitely a good kit, and it will allow then an installation into the car. Then we have two of these little caps. They are roughly 3 or 5 millimeter caps, so we can block off some hoses on the engine. If you don't block these hoses off, you will either have vacuum leaks or cooling leaks. So as you can see, what they look like this. And finally, there's one bigger hose block off coolant cap that you have to also get. And then your kit is basically complete for doing the swap. And of course, for you guys who know me a bit, you know what this is. So since I'm very much interested and I'm actually doing a lot of tuning, different customer cars, etc., sadly there isn't a more modern ECU available for this car. However, I have quite a fair bit of experience with the Apexi PowerFC. So this is the controller, as you probably all know. Very useful for showing knock and different parameters, doing minor settings. I wouldn't recommend to do any more than that. And with my beautiful Apexi ECU, this is what it looks like. Basically what happens is, you have commander, as you see here, will plug into here, and you even have the possibility of installing a boost control kit on this part here. So this is what it looks like. Stock ECU, 2ZZ ECU, stock, and the PowerFC. This will really be awesome. I'm looking forward to tuning the car with this. Thank you, Apexi, for always doing awesome prices for me. Also as a dealer, but also for my own project cars, I really want to thank you, Apexi Japan, and as of course, Apexi USA. They've also helped me out quite a lot. So many greetings to Mr. Nakanishi in Japan and Masaki in the US. And by the way, if it wasn't clear, so you will need either a PowerFC for 2ZZ Celica, that's the one I got, or the stock ECU. What's a problem with European ECUs is that these have an anti-theft system in the key. So the key is coded to the ECU. So what I did is, of the Corolla, I kept the electronical chip, and if need be, if I wanted to run the stock ECU, which we know will certainly not happen, I will use I can use actually the chip in the key, put it into my MR2 key, and actually run the car like that. It's really easy, and you know, I'll give the credit to the person who told me that. It's Stevie from Switzerland. He has an EP3 and a 200SX, so 180SX for the Japanese, and his brother actually gave us the idea to that, and very smart idea and clever idea. So in case it's possible to use the stock ECU, but as you all know, I really love engine mapping and tuning, so of course I will be using this instead. There is of course a key element that we need. I still need to work out if I want to do that or not. I will probably not be using this K&N filter since I'm an Apexi fan. So this is the intake, so basically the stock intake will not fit, the 2ZZ intake will not fit into the MR2. However, I have this intake kit that allows the swap, so it's a swap kit with all the hoses, clamps, and the airflow meter tube here, as you can see, fully ready to use with one of these hoses as well, and the cone will be installed on here. I will very surely use an Apexi filter instead. I'm not a big fan of K&N, to be honest. No disrespect intended towards them. It's just I like using what I'm used to using. So I use Apexi, so I will be using Apexi. And finally, a few things that are extra that I'm planning to change as well. I've gotten a brand new accessory belt. As you see, this one's totally destroyed. And one thing that I really didn't like in my MR2 is the sloppy shift feel. So I've gotten a Monkey Wrench Racing short shifter kit with all rigid bushings in order to improve the shift feel, especially with the six gearbox. I'm going to be going from 5 to 6 gears, so it's really important to have no misshifts. And one small accessory, this is also something very cool that I always wanted to buy for my MR2, and they've actually developed a little kit like this that allows you to have gauges. So typically I'll be using AFR for mapping, oil pressure and oil temperature. Probably that's what I'm going to be using. What would you use? Comment below. Obviously you will need the stock 2ZZ engine. You will be needing the stock intake manifold of the 2ZZ, all the sensors. You can use the 1ZZ knock sensor, the injectors of the 2ZZ, and of course the 2ZZ alternator is better than the 1ZZ because it can withhold high RPMs easier. I highly recommend that you get a 6-speed C60 transmission. The 5-speed isn't so well adapted to the 2ZZ rev range, so make sure to get the 6-speed. And of course, don't forget the clutch and the flywheel and the starter motor.
All right, we're back at the office. I think it's interesting also to maybe run down all the costs that have incurred until now for this 2ZZ swap. As you know, everything related to labor and dynoing, etc., are things that I do not need to pay for because I actually have my own dyno and my own workshop where I can do my modifications. So these prices are really just to show you from a hardware perspective, if I can say so, what it will cost you if you want to do a 2ZZ swap in an MR2. It just gives you a general idea, and I think it's interesting actually to know that, and it could actually inspire one or the other to actually do it yourself. So I'm going to break down the cost in three different groups. First of all, there's the swap kit. In a certain sense, that's all the monkey wrench parts, excluding the engine, the used engine, and the transmission, and also excluding the PowerFC ECU, the programmable one. So to run down the costs, I paid roughly for all the parts that you've seen in the video just now, 1,726 francs. That is including 7.7% Swiss VAT. In USD, it's 1,876. And on top of that, I bought a brand new Apexi PowerFC. It costs in Switzerland 1,350 Swiss francs. And that's where I was very lucky, is, you know, as I said in my previous video, there's two ways of going at a swap. Either you buy an engine by itself, a transmission by itself, and you put it all together, or you do like I did and you look for a pretty good car that is ideally running and do all the tests before actually taking everything out of the car, like we did in my previous video as well, the engine removal video. So basically, where I was really lucky, because this whole car that is from 2001 has 170,000 kilometers and actually is still, even now, even if it's a bare shell, is actually still road legal in Switzerland. It costed me only 1,800 Swiss francs. In USD, that's roughly 1,950 US dollars. That is really a bargain, at least in Switzerland. If not, tell me in the comments, because I know that in Europe, or at least in Central Europe, that is a relatively good price for a car like that. And in the end, I think it's a good idea to buy a whole car, because you get, in one purchase, you get everything that you need in order to do the swap from the used parts perspective, if we can say like that. ECU from the 2ZZ, the keys, the transmission, the full engine as well. So that's really, for me, is a bargain. If you think about it, 1800 Swiss francs just to get all of that in one go. So in the end, the total amount of all costs included in Swiss francs add up to 4,876 Swiss francs. And in USD, that's roughly 5,300. So if you think about it, $5,000 and you can have a full power increase to that level with a programmable ECU and everything is actually a fantastic deal. And I'd highly recommend this kind of swap to anybody who wants to build a mean machine out of their MR2. This is really an excellent solution in my opinion. And sometimes we even wonder why it wasn't even stock inside the car when it came from the factory. Anyhow, so this is really, I wanted to break this down to you. If you do it yourself like me, and you can actually get by with a really cheap price, and that's all it's gonna cost you. As you can also see, I've given the shell to a subscriber, so I didn't make any money off of that. I could have sold it probably a little bit, but I decided not to do that because in the end, I made a good deal on the purchase of the car originally. So anyway, one happy subscriber got the car. Anyway, I want to thank you also for supporting this channel and all of you guys watching all the time. I really appreciate it. And make sure, I know it's annoying, I'm always asking that, but make sure to subscribe, because on top of that, the next episodes that are coming out are going to be tearing down the 2ZZ engine, looking inside of it, actually getting an idea of the real state of the engine, if it's in good condition or not. I'm pretty sure it is, but who knows, we might have some surprises. And also fix the oil leaks. That's also a basic thing that I want to do and I want to show you. And just do like basic maintenance before putting it back together. So there will be also a transmission modification video, installing the LSD and the shifter conversion. And soon we'll be actually dropping the engine back into the MR2. I might actually make a short video on how to remove the engine from the MR2. That can be interesting. If you think so, comment below. And anyhow, I want to thank you very much for watching my videos. I'm pretty sure the upcoming videos are going to be really interesting, and I'm looking forward to showing that to you. So take care and see you soon. Peace. Thank you so much for watching the episode until the end. I really appreciate that. If you like what you saw, do not forget to subscribe. Like this, you can see all our episodes we post. If you have any comments or questions, make sure to shoot us a comment below. Until then, see you next week.